Hi, let's check in with Jensen Dennis from Business in Vancouver. Good morning, Jen.
Good morning.
Let's start off with this new report. I can't wait to see what you're going to say with this one. Vancouver compared to other cities around Canada, around the world. Who did this, first of all?
Yeah, well, this is a report done by the Vancouver Board of Trade and also by the Conference Board of Canada. The Conference Board of Canada was the agency that did the actual analysis. And so this report is really interesting because it compares Vancouver not just with Canadian cities, not just with cities in the United States, but also some cities in Europe and also in Asia as well. And it's 20 cities in all. Vancouver ends up coming out ninth when it comes to the economic measures and seventh when it comes to social measures. So we don't do that badly. We're kind of in the middle of the pack, and there are some things in our favor, like we're in a beautiful location. We also are in a good geographic location for trade, so our port and our airport are really important. We actually have some low office rents, which sort of raised our ranking. And then in the social category, you know, we have clean air, we have a nice city, we have low crime rates, especially compared to some of the American cities. But there are definitely some things that we could improve on. And probably the biggest one is housing affordability. As we know, it's become very, very expensive to live here, and that can be you know, a negative when it comes to attracting a talented workforce. Now, compared to some of the cities outside Canada, we also have a low proportion of young people living in our city, and so that's another talent thing. And we also, you know, that PST is actually also still a negative, so that's contributing to some of the downside on the economic.
All right, interesting details in that. Some of those things we kind of know already, right?
And, yeah, that's right. And there's some things that, you know, sort of continue to be as something that's a concern for the business community, like the low head office count. Actually, we have low labor productivity as well, and we actually have the highest income inequality compared to the other Canadian cities. So definitely some concerns. There are some things to work on.
Okay.
Sure.
I know that the Kinder Morgan pipeline expansion project, that is back in the headlines, the federal government stepping in. What can you tell us about that?
Yeah, no, this is sort of an ad hoc measure that they're doing. So the National Energy Board, which is the agency that recommends whether pipelines should be approved or not to the federal government, they've really been criticized for being too industry-focused, and especially in the era of the Stephen Harper government. Too industry-focused, not really listening enough to community and First Nations and environmental concerns. So the federal government of Justin Trudeau has promised to sort of reform the NEB, and they're in the midst of doing that. But in the meantime, we have all these pipelines on the go, and one of them is the Kinder Morgan expansion. And so for this particular project, the government has appointed this three-person panel. It's made up of Kim Baird, a former chief of the Tsawwassen First Nation, also a former deputy minister of Alberta, and the former premier of the Yukon. And so they are going to be sort of supplementing the panel and looking into whether communities and First Nations were properly consulted. And they're also going to be looking at the greenhouse gas emissions, which has also been an important add-on to the NEB process that this government has put in place. And they'll be reporting out to government in November.
All right, Jen, thanks very much for the update on both of those stories. Thank you.
Thank you.
Have a great day. All right.